there it was, the unifier. Now the Trebhum would have to be brave and clever and find a way of defeating this dreadful creature. So they could claim the ingredient they needed to transform themselves. Triangle-shaped objects that had fallen from the unifier's head must be the ingredients the Trebhum needed for the mutation.
Thank you.
Now that the Trebhum had transformed themselves, they would need to find the largest crystal formation in the area. That would be their best chance at tricking the mathematician into absorbing them. Once again, the Trebhum had returned to the strange place in the giant's dreams. There were more mysteries to uncover, more memories to take back. The voice seemed even stronger now. Yes, yes, I can almost speak. Let me tell you your story. The song of your people is rich and beautiful. Before the cylinder came, each generation passed on its memories to the next. And so you learned to avoid repeating your mistakes. Slowly, you discovered the secrets of your world. You built great cities full of wonders. And then you sang to the stars to find others like you, to share in the joys of existence. When you sang to the stars, there were many who heard you and raised their voices in song. Most are gone now, save for the Trawala, your oldest friends. When we heard your song, it was already too late for us. The cylinder was upon us, and there was nothing we could do. But we are not that different from you. We are also not strong or fast, and we don't have sharp teeth, but we are stubborn. The cylinder creates its minions from pieces of what it absorbs. So we found a way to help you. All of us together, these fragments of my people, the memories of your ancestors, and what's left of all those others who shared our fate, a conspiracy of ghosts to sabotage the cylinder and give you a chance. There is more to be found, memories to be reclaimed, and what you need in order to... But our fragments are fading. Being absorbed, these moments of strength are rare. I am only... But the voice could not continue. Once more, it was only a memory. what was this artificial island on the horizon? Could it be what the Trebhum had been told to search for? Could their adventure be nearing an end? With the knowledge they had gained, all they now needed to do was to catch a specific kind of fish, which would allow them to acquire the wonderful ability to swim without ever getting tired. Trebhum were happy to find a friend resting on the island. However, They quickly realized he was not well. The elder told them, "What a pleasant surprise to find a group of such brave little adventurers. Oh, I'm glad to see your faces before my end. I'm sorry to tell you that this structure will not ascend on its own. I was hoping someone might bring the lenses that power this palace before the cylinder came, but as I can see, you do not know of what I speak, and this is simply not to be. But fear not, there are other palaces in the waters of this great desert, and resting in the golden dunes of these marvelous plains, you will find the hidden treasures that can awaken and lift to their majestic heights the Trebhum palaces that were once the pride of our people. Swim over to the other side and seek the Trawala that guards my brother's temple. He will explain what you must do. I wish you luck. Know that my spirit will dance and sing when you succeed where I have failed." The Trebhum sensed that something was roaming the desert, something that did not belong there. No doubt the Eternal Cylinder had once again sent forth its cruel servants. Perhaps it had taken notice of the Trebhum and was seeking to stop them from accomplishing their goals.
Yeah.
The projection shared a new recipe with the Trebhum, which could protect them from the cruel light of their enemies. Thank you. The Trebhum was surprised to see this temple was protected by some sort of defense mechanism. Was this some futile attempt to keep out the servants of the cylinder? Or was there another reason, now lost to history? Seeing the celestial Trawala, the Trebhum were reminded of all the many creatures that had fallen before the cylinder. Somewhere out there waited an elder who did not know of his sibling's fate, and the Trebhum felt the weight of the bad news they carried.